Today, we are going to continue with amplifiers, feedback amplifier design. In the last class, lecture 15, we had started with how to design negative feedback amplifiers, ideal amplifiers, and today we will be continuing with the methodology of feedback amplifier design. We have already classified ideal amplifiers as voltage amplifiers, current amplifiers, transconductance amplifiers and transresistance amplifiers. These are the ideal amplifiers which have a unique way of representation, voltage amplifier being represented by G, actually it should be G, current amplifier by H. In fact, there is a mistake here. So, voltage amplifier by G, current amplifier by H, okay, transconductance amplifier by in fact here also, transresistance amplifier by Z, and transconductance amplifier by Y. So, we have these ways of representing ideal amplifiers, and what is the feedback for obtaining voltage amplifier? Voltage amplifiers can be obtained by H feedback, which is the inverse of G feedback. So, where the H parameters add and the inverse of H is resulting in G. So, voltage amplifier is represented by G matrix. In order to reach the G matrix, we have to start with H feedback. That means, H parameter of the amplifier adds with H parameter of the feedback networks, so that it becomes a series arrangement at the input and shunt arrangement at the output. Series arrangement input increases the input impedance, shunt arrangement at the output decreases the output impedance. So, it reaches an idealization of voltage controlled voltage source. So, you can see here, current amplifier on the other hand is ideally represented by H parameter. So, we start with G feedback in order to reach idealization. The G feedback, okay, inverted results in the H matrix. The G feedback topology is where G parameters add, it is shunt at the input, admittances add, series at the output, impedances add. So, it becomes current controlled current source. So, it is an ideal current amplifier realization. G parameters add and inverted G results in ideal H. So, transconductance amplifier, the ideal matrix is represented by Y matrix. So, that means this Y is the inversion of Z matrix. Z parameters add both at the input and at the output. So, it is series at the input and series at the output. So, the amplifier becomes a voltage controlled current source, and it is ideally represented by a Y parameter, which is the inverse of the Z parameter. The transresistance amplifier on the other hand is ideally represented by Z, which is the inverse of Y. Y parameters add if they are in shunt at the input and shunt at the output. So, the Y parameters add and inverted Y is the Z parameter of the transresistance idealization. So, these are the procedures, these are the topologies of feedback arrangement, okay. This is the mathematical technique of adding the parameter simply and inverting to get what we want, adding the parameter simply and getting the inversion what we want. So this is the way it is going to start, right? If you want a current amplifier, okay, which is the H parameter, you start with G. If you want a voltage amplifier, which is the G parameter, okay, you start with the H. So if you want a transconductance amplifier, you start with Z, okay. If you want transresistance amplifier, you start with Y. So let us, we have demonstrated this procedure very clearly earlier in the 15th lecture by designing Y feedback, that is realization of Z matrix, okay. So the trans impedance amplifier was designed systematically, and we gave an example of such a trans impedance amplifier design. We are now going to design a general amplifier topology, okay. So that was also illustrated by taking immutance matrix, and today the examples are chosen on the other three amplifiers: voltage amplifier, trans impedance amplifier and current amplifiers. These three examples are going to be illustrated in today's examples. So let us start with the voltage amplifier design. So ideal voltage control voltage source, okay. So the procedure is going to be that we have to start with the ideal amplifier matrix, which is the G matrix, 0, 0, 0 it should be, and GF, which is independent of the amplifier parameters. It should be dependent only on the feedback network parameter. So this is what we want to achieve, which means we go to the H parameters for the amplifier, non-ideal amplifier. H parameter of the non-ideal amplifiers will be adding with the H parameter of the suitable feedback network, okay, in order to sort of get the ideal G, we have to invert the composite H matrix. So let us consider this amplifier now. HIA is going to be nothing but RIA. HIA is the H parameter of this amplifier, that means it is shorted at the output, and HIA is nothing but the impedance seen at the input when the output is shorted. Since there is no feedback, whatever we do at the output has no role, okay, at the input. So it is nothing but straight away RIA. HOIA on the other hand is open circuit the input and open circuit admittance at the output. So it is nothing but HOA is 1 over ROA. Next, HFA is the short circuit current gain. The current at the input, if it is II, so II is the current at the input. This generates a voltage at the input, which is RIA into II, okay. That into A is the voltage, okay, at the output, which gets transferred. That divided by ROA is the short circuit current, and since it is going to flow, case when this is positive negative, this will be positive and this is negative, okay. It is II RIA A divided by ROA is the output current, short circuit current with a negative sign, because it is going to flow out. Current flowing in is considered as positive. So what is the short circuit current gain? HFA is nothing but A times RIA by ROA. So HFA is minus A times RIA divided by ROA. So the other parameters are this for the amplifier that is going to be used here. The feedback arrangement to obtain near ideal voltage control voltage source. So, the this is the arrangement, it is shunt at the output, so that output impedance comes down, it becomes a voltage control device, because input impedance is increasing, right? They are in series. So, current is common, okay, voltages add, okay, add input voltage to the amplifier as to the feedback voltage to the network, right, of the passive feedback network. And here it is in shunt, that means output current of the amplifier and output current of the feedback, they get added and output current is obtained. So, the feedback network in this particular case is nothing but a attenuator network, okay. So, this is R1, this is R2, this is the feedback network that is going to be used here to modify the property of this amplifier, so that it becomes an ideal, near ideal voltage controlled voltage source, shunt at the output, series at the input. So, this is the way parameters act, that means the G parameter of the amplifier now, okay, adds with H parameter of the amplifier adds with the H parameter of the feedback network in order to give you the composite network. This is the feedback network R2 and R1, output voltages fed back to the input. VFB by VO is R1 by R1 plus R2. So, again H parameter of this is R1 parallel R2 when you short this, okay. So, the H parameter of this is R1 parallel R2, okay, and the HF feed forward here from this to this is going to be current, short circuit current is going to be R1 by R1 plus R2 with a negative sign, and then the open circuit the input and the admittance 1 over R1 plus R2, that is the admittance of this open circuit admittance, and the feedback when you open circuit voltage at the input for an output voltage is R1 by R1 plus R2 positive. So, I can see that the HR feedback is same as HF feedback, okay, feed forward, only opposite in sign. That is the case with H and G parameters in general of passive networks, okay. So, we have now written this composite the G parameters, composite H parameters of the whole network and converted it into G parameters inverse here. This is the G matrix. So, this G matrix comes by transforming the composite H matrix, okay, and its inverse. So, you have the feedback parameters getting added with the amplifier network H parameter, and the H parameter is inverted to give you the G matrix as shown here. So, this is the inverted G matrix of the network. So, you can see that this is nothing but 1 over PR of the feedback network, which is 1 plus R2 over R1. R1 by R1 plus R2 inverse of that is 1 plus R2 over R1. And the rest of the parameters you can see clearly here that the loop gain of the whole system, okay, makes this rest of the parameters all go towards 0, because A is very large, okay, RIA may be also pretty large, RO is very small. This is what I call as, okay, zeroth, that is 0 of third order, because this is going towards 0, this is going towards infinity, this is going towards infinity. this is a third order zero. That means this is definitely going fast towards zero. This is 1 over a, okay, first order 0, second order 0. So, this is a second order 0. This is again a second order 0. This is finite. So, it is very clear that we have achieved a voltage controlled voltage source of gain 1 plus R2 over R1 nearing the ideal element values for the other parameters of the matrix, D matrix. This is the model, right? This will be very high impedance, okay, or very low conductance, okay. This is also very high impedance, or in fact very low resistance. Not, this is the output impedance which is becoming very low. Output conductance is, okay, going to be very high. So, this is going towards voltage controlled voltage source. So, we have reached this voltage controlled voltage source that we desire with very high input impedance seen here, which is equal to the original impedance into loop gain, which is A of this stage. Loop gain is roughly this, you can just note that approximately it can be evaluated very quickly, okay. This is the impedance that comes in between. So, if the gain is A and this attenuation is R1 by R1 plus R2, the loop gain is roughly equal to R1 by R1 plus R2 into A, okay. If you ignore the effect of loading due to this on R1, okay. So, what happens is loop gain in this case is roughly equal to A into R1 by R1 plus R2. So, the input impedance of the amplifier gets enhanced roughly to this value, original value into the loop gain. This is the new impedance, that means impedance goes very high, and output impedance should be reduced. It is going to be reduced by the same factor of the loop gain. So, it goes towards 0, this goes towards infinity. That is how it is becoming voltage controlled voltage source, and the gain becomes only dependent upon the inverse transfer parameter here, which is 1 over inverse transfer parameter, 1 over R1 by R1 plus R2, or 1 plus R2 by R1. So, an example, we want to design using 741, for example, okay, an op amp with nearly 10 to power 6, 10 to power 5 to 10 to power 6 decibels, that is 100 to 120 decibels of gain, DC gain, input resistance of 1 mega ohm, output resistance of 100 ohm. Let us say RS is source resistance 10k and RL is also 10k. Let us consider the design of a non-inverting amplifier of gain 100. Now, 1 plus R2 over R1 is equal to 100, because 1 over feedback parameter R1 by R1 plus R2 is this. So, R2 by R1, okay, you get it as 99. So, R2 is equal to 99 R1. So, we can actually say that R1 plus R2 is equal to 100 R1. So, substituting these values, you will note that the GI that you have as the first parameter of the G matrix, inverted matrix, going towards 0, 10 to power minus 10, you can see. And you can also have a means of finding out what should be the value of R1 plus R2 in order to make this negligible, okay. this is the output impedance. In order to make this insensitive to the output impedance, you have to select R1 plus R2 accordingly. That means if you select R1 plus R2 much greater than 100, you have desensitized it with respect to the output impedance. Similarly, as far as input impedance is concerned, you can actually desensitize with respect to input impedance, okay, if RS, okay, plus R1 parallel R2 is chosen to be much lower than input impedance, okay, which can be approximated to 0. G0 is also coming out to be approximate to 0, right. So, this is output impedance. GR is going to be the reverse transmission after feedback. This is also very nearly 0, minus 10 to power minus 10, ROA by A into RIA. This is the third order 0 I am talking about. So, these are the conditions that must be fulfilled in order to make these things insensitive to input impedance of the amplifier and output impedance of the amplifier. R1 plus R2 should be much greater than 100 ohms and RAA should be much greater than R1 parallel R2. All resistors are, so this is the way resistors are selected. So, actually speaking, I think funnel diagram, there is, this was started as 10K, it does not make much of an influence, right. So, this is the final circuit which gives us a voltage control voltage source with gain equal to 100. The next to design is the voltage control current source, transconductance amplifier. Transconductance amplifiers are pretty common in high frequency filter design to these days, analog multiplexers, sample and hold circuit, modulators and mixers. In fact, op amp was relatively first offered as a transconductance type of op amp, okay, for these communication applications like modulators and mixers. These are the one TI-3080, OPA-860, these types. Let us see how we will go about designing an ideal voltage control current source. As you can see there, control voltage Vi results in an output current of Gm times Vi coming into the port. So, the matrix that we are interested in reaching when we go to the idealization is nothing but the Y matrix I naught in terms of Y matrix when the independent variables are Vi and V0. So, Y matrix will be 0, 0, 0 and Gm, which is independent of the amplifier active device parameters, dependent solely on the passive device. Feedback around non-ideal amplifier to convert it into a voltage controlled current source, okay. So, this is for a current control, voltage control current source. So, voltage controlled again means that input impedance should go high. Current source means output impedance should go high. So, the arrangement is series at the input and series at the output. And what is the parameter that adds? You have to start with, we want an ideal Y parameter. So, we have to start with Z parameters, and the Z parameters, which are called open circuit parameters, add simply. VIA adds to VIP, VOA adds to VOP, and the final load voltage occurs here and final input voltage occurs here. So, the current is common both at the input and the output. This should be strictly II. So input current is common, both at the input and output current is common for both the ports. So this is the topology for a voltage controlled current source realization. Z parameters are the ones to be taken and added. So let us consider the Z parameters for the non-ideal active device. So ZIA equals RIA, because the reverse transmitter parameter is 0, input and output are isolated. So this is simply ZIA, and this one is simply ZOA is equal to ROA. Now what is the ZFA for this? So ZFA is defined as, when you have an input current of II, okay, II into RIA is the input voltage, that times A is the open circuit voltage at the output. So let us see the polarity. This is plus and that is minus, so it is positive. So we have the Z parameter of this in this manner, RIA, ROA, and this ZFA is nothing but, okay, this is ZFA, okay. So let us see the composite. Actually feedback network is going to be again nothing but an impedance between the output and input, okay. So this is the feedback network. So it is just a network ZF. So what is the Z parameter of this? It will be ZF, I mean II pumped into this will result in a voltage which is II into ZF, okay. So ZF at the output, open circuit parameters of this feedback network, okay, minus ZF and minus ZF here, because when I pump a current through this, the voltage is going to be minus ZF into II, okay, at the output. Similarly, if I pump a current from the output, it will be minus ZF into IO, right, because this total arrangement is going to be coming like this. So you can see that the grounding is done for this. If we use single ended differential input, single ended output op amp is used, this is already grounded, and this ground comes here. So these voltages will be getting added with this as positive. And when I am pumping II, okay, this develops II into RF, and that will be in opposition to this voltage. So if this is AV IA, which is A into RIA into II, this is going to be minus that. So that's how, okay, that minus sign is attributed to both feedback and feed forward parameters of the feedback network. So the composite Z parameter is going to be this A times RIA with this as minus, okay, this as plus, okay, and then this as plus RF. Is one way of looking at it for that particular direction for which we have marked, right. We can consider it as plus and this as minus and this as minus. So this is one way of looking at the whole thing, right. It depends upon the direction in which we have marked the current. So if you have marked I naught as this, then actually this particular thing is going to be plus here, minus here, minus that, as we had indicated earlier, right. So this will be minus here, okay, and plus here when it is inverted, plus here, okay. So the determinant, okay, of the matrix is changing the parameters this way, that this becomes equal to, okay, minus 1 over RF. This is RF, RF gets sort of ARIA, minus 1 over RF is the parameter this it is reaching. This is going towards 0, 0 and 0. That is the final Y matrix of this whole thing. So this is the network. This voltage Vs is going to carry, make this RF carry a current of Vs by RF. Vs appears here, this is Vs. So this is Vs by RF, okay. And that current is going to flow in the opposite direction to what is marked as IL. So that transfer parameter is minus 1 over RF. Design a voltage controlled current source with transconductance of 1 millisiemens for a source with RS equal to 10 kilo ohm and with a load of 1 kilo ohm using 741 op amp. 741 is a general purpose voltage op amp with DC voltage gain of 10 to power 5, 100 decibels, input resistance RIA 1 mega ohm and output resistance of ROE equal to 100 ohm, RF is equal to 1 kilo ohm. This is what is chosen in order to make the conductance 1 millisiemen. So we have it here now according to us. This is going to be plus and this is going to be minus for that particular direction marked, okay. That is the only way. If you change the direction there up in the block to the opposite direction as positive, then this will retain the previous sign. And here it is minus and this is plus, okay. And therefore this becomes now, okay, minus. Plus, this becomes minus. So this minus plus, this is plus. So you can see that ultimately, for the values that we have given there, the determinant of the matrix is 10 to power 14, A into RA into RF roughly, okay. And it is that magnifies this matrix parameters. So A comes everywhere in the denominator. Here it gets cancelled and therefore it is minus 1 over RF. So you can see that Y matrix goes towards 0, 0, 0 and minus 1 millisiemens. Design a voltage control current source with transconductance of 1 millisiemens for a source resistance of RS equal to 10 kilo ohm and load resistance of 1 kilo ohm using TL081 op amp. TL081 is a general purpose BiFET voltage op amp with the DC voltage gain of 10 to power 5, 100 decibels, input resistance of 10 to power 6 mega ohms and output resistance of 100 ohms. You will see that the Y matrix of such a network now becomes 10 to power minus 14, close to 0, minus 10 to power minus 17, again very close to 0 and 10 to power minus 14. That is the order. Compared to 10 to power minus 3. So this becomes 0 compared to this 1 millisiemens. It is totally independent of the device parameters. Finally, we come to the current control current source, current amplifier. With the supply voltages getting reduced to even less than 1 volt, and the present day amplifiers have to become current amplifiers. In order to deliver a required amount of power, the only swing that can be achieved is current swing. So the future of current amplifier is very bright compared to voltage amplifiers, where voltage swings are in demand and supply voltages have to be very large for that. This is not strictly compatible with the current day technology of supply voltage reduction in order to keep up with the advances or in digital design. Operational current amplifiers are for some reason not very popular commercially, okay, but they have to become popular in future. So what is the ideal current amplifier? It is current controlled, short circuit at the input and a current source. Please note that output is shorted. Same thing we should have done with voltage controlled current source, that the output should be kept shorted in order to deliver zero power, and keeping it open is a mistake. Here Vi and I naught are the dependent variable, Ii and V naught are the independent variable, and this matrix has 0, 0, 0 and HF independent of the active device and dependent solely on the passive network that is used for feedback, ideally represented by H parameters. The arrangement of feedback is, since it is current control shunt at the input, since it is a current source, series at the output. So currents add here, voltages add at the output. Input impedance can be brought down by current control by shunt arrangement at the input, and output impedance can be increased by series arrangement at the output. So we have the composite matrix now, actually the network is going to be the amplifier network here, which has to be put RIA, and we are going to start with the we have to ultimately obtain an ideal H matrix. We have to start with G matrix for the amplifier, adds with G matrix of the feedback network, and this has to be, the whole thing has to be inverted to get the H matrix, ideal H matrix with 0, 0, 0 and HF independent of the amplifier parameters. So this is going to be ROA, this is going to be A times VI. So the feedback network is going to be such that we can introduce the feedback network. So you can introduce the feedback network here, right, such that the current here, portion of the current here is fed back as voltage at this point, right. So the current is sensed here and fed back as current into the feedback. Okay. So current sensing is done by putting a resistance across it. And feeding it back as current, okay, at the output. Okay, So this is the composite arrangement, and let us see what happens to the G matrix that we get here. We start with G matrix, add 1 over RIA is the G parameter at the input of the amplifier, 1 over R1 plus R2 is that due to the feedback network, okay, at the input, okay, plus 1 over RS due to the source, and the feedback is R1 by R1 plus R2. Okay, and as far as current is concerned, and this one is A plus R1 by R1 plus R2, right. Actually there is a negative sign associated with this, okay. This is the current fed back, okay. So this is negative feedback because loop gain is determined mainly by this into this divided by this into this, okay. So the H matrix is going to be this divided by determinant of the matrix minus this divided by again determinant. So here, since A is coming both at the numerator and denominator, this particular thing is finite and all these three parameters go to 0. This 1 plus R2 over R1 it becomes, okay. So this is actually the current gain minus . So this is the current amplifier that is designed here. You can see that this is the G parameter getting added to the G parameter of this. Our current is sensed at the output and current fed back to the input is minus R1 by R1 plus R2. Okay. So that is incorporated as a composite, okay, the G matrix. So this is the feedback arrangement, this is the load. So this is where V0 is taken. This is I0, okay, this is V0 across the load. So we have this current gain I0 by II becoming equal to 1 plus R2 over R1. With the negative sign, totally independent of the active device parameters. Okay. So this is the final current control current source. Okay. Source resistance, load resistance, R1 and R2. This current II goes through this, develops a potential II into R2, that gets dropped across R1. Because this potential is nearly 0. So that II into R2 by R1 flows through this, this way these two add on the output current. So in conclusion, we have seen here that before we end, we can also give an example here. Let us say same example, okay. This is say 99K and this is 1K. Then the current gain is 100, okay, because 1 plus 99 by 1 equal to 100 with a negative value. Current going in, this is going to be going out, okay. So minus 100. So these impedances don't matter at all. ROA, okay. So if this is VI, this is minus A times VI, which is same as VI. So this is how we compute the whole thing, okay. Conclusion is that we have shown how starting with H matrix to get ideal G matrix, which is voltage controlled voltage source, we can design voltage amplifiers. Starting with G matrix, okay, adding G parameters of the amplifier and the feedback network, getting H matrix, we can design current controlled current sources or current amplifiers. We can start with Y matrix, Y parameters add, and reach ideal Z matrix and design trans impedance amplifiers. Start with Z matrix, lead to ideal Y matrix and get trans conductance amplifiers or trans impedance amplifiers. So the amplifier design procedure for feedback amplifier design is just this. We can use this concept, for example, using even transistors. So now I can tell you how using transistors in place of op amp. I can design this using this as the active device. Okay, what are the parameters of this? Let us say we want to design a trans impedance amplifier or trans resistance amplifier using transistors. So what is the procedure? We have to start with the Y matrix for this. So this GIA is 0, and if you have VI here, GM times VI is the current in the output. So short circuit current at the output is GM times VI, where VI is the input voltage. So current goes in, since its equivalent circuit is for the MOSFET, okay, GM times VI, and then we have what you call as output conductance GDS. All these things we have already discussed when we discussed the MOSFET, okay, earlier as active device. So this is GDS, this is 0. This is the active device parameter, okay. This has to add to GS here, source resistance, this GL here, okay. And then the feedback network is GF. So we have this as GL, this as GS, and the current at the input is IS. So we can now find out the this is actually speaking GF here, and this gets added to GF here. This is minus GF, this is minus GF, this is plus GF. So actual parameter, composite parameter, Y parameter of this is GS plus GF minus GF, GM minus GF, okay, GDS plus GL plus GF. So the determinant of the matrix, okay, is going to be this into this minus this into this. So you will see that it is not having, because this GF squared gets cancelled with this GF squared, okay. So the determinant of the matrix simply becomes, okay, GS plus GF into GDS plus GL plus GF plus GF into GM minus GF. Okay. So it is essentially GS, okay, into GDS plus GL plus GF, okay, plus GF into GDS plus GL plus GM into GF. This actually dominates the whole scene, right? And a good MOSFET is a device where GM is very large compared to all other conductances. GM is much greater than all other G's. That's how you have to build a MOS circuit. If such is the case, then if you now obtain the Z parameter of this composite network, you will see that the Z parameter will have, okay, assuming that this is approximately equal to GM into GF, okay, if GM dominates, then the whole thing is going to be divided by GDS plus GL plus GF divided by GM into GF, goes towards 0. Okay. The other one is GS plus GF divided by GM into GF, goes towards 0. This is GF DF gets cancelled, 1 over GM itself. Okay. This is approximately equal to GM because this is negligible. Okay. So we have this 1 over GF with a negative sign. So this is what happens ultimately, therefore this is equal to 0, 0, 0 and then minus RF. This is how we design a transistor based trans resistance amplifier. It is so simple as that. Using either MOSFET or bipolar, it does not make any difference. The equivalent circuit will have a modification here at the input also in the case of bipolar, that is all. But the procedure is exactly similar to this. Now similarly, one can design a trans conductance amplifier by using a MOSFET or a bipolar structure. What is done in such a situation is that this topologically this is the active device, and we are introducing the resistance RF as feedback resistance here. So this is the topology of series at the input and series at the output. So trans conductance amplifier. Let us say we have a finite input resistance here. This can take into account the leakage etcetera at the input. So if this is infinity, then 1 over RIA goes towards 0, that is all. So the parameter that you have to use will be Z parameters to start with. So once again you have this Z. For the amplifier, Z parameter is RIA. For the feedback network, it is RF. Okay. And then the output, it is RDS, which is 1 over GDS plus RF. Nothing from the amplifier as far as reverse transformation is concerned, but as far as feedback is concerned, we have minus Rf. If this considered as I naught, this considered as II. So minus Rf, right? Oh, sorry, plus Rf here. If this considered as I naught, and this will be again plus Rf. Okay. And as far as amplifier is concerned, the input current is II into RIA, okay, that gets multiplied by GM of the FET, okay, that is the current, and that flows through, okay, that current will be flowing in and it will flow through this RDS and negative voltage will appear, so negative into RDS. So that is the Z parameter, which is minus RIA GM RDS. So that means actually this is negligible, okay, compared to this. So it is negative feedback because this into this, okay, with the negative sign it comes, divided by this into this is the loop gain. So the determinant of the matrix is nearly equal to RIA GM RDS into RF. So that is it. So that is what modifies this, and you get the final Y parameter as this divided by RDS plus RF. If you want to add the load resistance here, you can add, okay, you can add the source resistance here, right. So RL divided by the loop gain RIA GM RDS RF. So we get this as the what is that, final Y parameters of the network, okay. Again here this goes to minus this divided by the same thing, and here it is RIA plus RF plus RS divided by RIA GM RDS into RF. Here it is nothing but 1 over RF. So it is essentially equal to 0, 0, 0, 1 over RF. So even for transistors this can be applied, and one can design transconductance and transresistance amplifiers. Couple these transconductance with transresistance, you get a voltage controlled voltage source. Couple trans resistance with transconductance, you get a current controlled current source. So that means all the four types of amplifiers can be easily realized, and these are the structures which are really the integrated circuit feedback amplifiers which are used. Particularly more number of stages cause the order of the system to increase and make the system become unstable, and therefore it is common practice to use single stage structures, okay, for local negative feedback topology. That means transconductance and transresistance are simple structures which may not give problem in terms of stability in structures. Therefore, voltage control voltage source and current control current sources can be obtained by cascading these rather than using complex structures like pair for H and G feedback.